All right, so today we're going to look at some tips and tricks for how to work from home more productively and also how to study from home if that's what you're doing. So let's do that. Okay, so now that a lot of jobs are being able to be performed via just a laptop, that basically means that the need for a real workplace is kind of decreasing and more people are working from home. And that's one of the things that I think is going to be a positive outcome of this pandemic thing, is that more and more companies have realized that a lot of their jobs that they have employees for can actually be performed from home. So they don't actually need their employees to come into work to be able to perform their jobs. And I think that's going to lead to more remote type of job opportunities in the future. And with this thing that seems really positive comes a lot of new challenges and things that we haven't really faced before, or a lot of us haven't faced before. And that can be simple things like just basically getting off your phone in the morning without wasting your entire day away scrolling through your phone. And it could be more complex things as well, like things that are harder to pin down and kind of unexpected about it. Things like feeling exhausted even though you basically work a little bit less and you also are able to sleep in as much as you want, but you still end up feeling really exhausted and feeling like you have no energy to actually work. A lot of these challenges are new to a lot of us and it can be really difficult to figure out how to deal with them, but do not worry because I'm here to save you since I have life completely figured out. No, but I do have some really good tips that I've been using that have really helped me improve my productivity when working from home. And I found that because of these tips, I'm able to have these days when I'm really not that productive at all. Because when using these tips, I'm able to basically compensate on those days when I'm able to implement them for the days when I'm not able to implement them, if that makes any sense. So that's what I'm going to share with you today. Here we go. The first tip is reading at the start of your day. And this was stolen from a recent podcast with Tim Ferriss, where he interviews Hugh Jackman.
I nicked the idea from Patrick Stewart, and he said to me that when he was about 60, he realized that he was never going to read all the books that he wanted to read in his life. He did the calculation. And so he decided that no matter what time his call was, let's say he's picked up at 5, whatever time he would have woken up, he wakes up 30 minutes earlier, gets a cup of tea and goes back to bed and he reads. And he said, I don't read the paper because it makes me angry. I don't read my emails because it usually makes me anxious. And we read for at least 30 minutes and then we meditate together. And that way it's become our like favorite time of the day as a couple. We know that no matter what happens in the day, which invariably gets away from you, you've had that quality time together.
And the way that I implement this is I recently bought a Kindle, which I've been really loving and enjoying reading on, and that has led me to read a little bit more. Anyway, that was a sidetrack. What I've been doing is I've basically left the Kindle next to my bed, and the first thing that I do when I wake up, I don't check my phone, I don't do anything else. I just open up the Kindle and start reading the book that I'm currently on. And that has really been a really good thing for me. I've been actually reading now for 2 weeks, I think. Every morning for about an hour it ends up being. And that's one of the goals that I've had for a while now, is basically just to read more and specifically to learn new things that I can then implement on this channel. And I've been really bad at doing that. So what I used to do was basically say that I'll read at the end of my day, because reading wasn't really the main priority. My main priority is like making videos and coding different things. So therefore it seemed like it was secondary to everything else. But that also meant that I would usually in the afternoon end up postponing things and just feeling like, I can't really be bothered. And usually what happens is that towards the end of the day, your motivation kind of fades, or my motivation at least fades away. And that means that I'm more likely to end up just watching Netflix or something instead of actually doing some reading. And also reading first thing in the morning has had the side benefit or effect of me basically feeling or being more productive throughout the rest of my day as well. And that's something that I don't know if it's a like cause-effect relationship, whether it's the fact that I'm in a more productive period right now and that's why I'm reading, or whether it's the reading that makes me more productive. But either way, I kind of feel like that reading in the morning that I want to do is a task that I'm able to complete that kind of triggers me being more productive with the rest of my day. Anyway, it's a really good tip from Uncle Jackman. The second tip is to postpone joy, which is a tip from Jocko Willink, who is a Navy SEAL. You may have heard of him. And I really like this tip because it's a really simple way of exercising discipline.
Don't take today off. Wait until tomorrow. If, when tomorrow comes, you still feel like you need to rest or you need to take a break, then okay.
And what I've found is that most often, like Jocko Willink said, you'll end up not actually needing the satisfaction or the thing that you wanted to do. You'll end up maybe working 2 hours instead of the 1 hour that you set out to work. And that's a really good way of just being more productive, basically postponing joy and preponing discomfort, because that's essentially what you're doing usually is the opposite. You want to avoid the discomfort of actually starting the essay, which is uncomfortable, and you want to instead do something that feels more joyful, like scrolling through Instagram or watching a YouTube video. So that's a really good way of just exercising your discipline and just being able to get more disciplined with doing the hard things first and then the things that are easy to do or like enjoyable. The third tip is to use games or entertainment as rewards. One of the benefits of working from home is being able, or like the freedom that it allows you to have. And you don't want to remove this because otherwise, what's the point? You might as well go into an office. So I think that this is something that's really important. And I think that when we're working from home, we feel guilty when we're not working. So it's really hard to find that balance between the work and the free time. So a good way to do this is to kind of reward yourself with the things that you want to do, the entertainment that you want to be partaking in. The way that I do this is I basically either set a task or a time limit of some kind. So maybe I have to film a video or I have to complete a script or something like that. And then after I've done that, I allow myself to play my favorite game or to watch my favorite show. Whatever I feel like doing at that time, I will allow myself to do that. But an important point here is also to set a time limit for the entertainment and to set an alarm for the entertainment, because otherwise you usually end up spending more time on the entertainment and less time on the productive thing that you need to be doing. This is something that you have to figure out on your own. You have to figure out what is realistic. Do you feel like you have 2 hours to spend playing a game after doing 30 minutes of writing? Or do you feel like you may need to do 3 hours of writing and then 30 minutes of game playing? I suggest using it in whichever way you want and whichever way kind of makes sense. But it is a really good way to just, first of all, not feel guilty about playing the game that you want to do, because no matter how small the task that you've completed beforehand, you've actually said to yourself that after I complete this task, I'm allowed to play this game. And that makes you feel like you've actually accomplished something beforehand. So that's a really good tip that I think we should be utilizing, because you shouldn't just be spending your days working. It's not the goal when you're working from home to spend more time working than you do at your actual work if you go into an office. Okay, and tip number four is to not eat in front of your TV or in front of your phone or any sort of entertainment. I found this to be a really useful advice because I myself make my breakfast and then I'll sit down in front of the TV and watch some show of some kind on Netflix or whatever else. And usually it doesn't take me 21 minutes, which is like the average of a TV series. It usually takes about 10 minutes to actually finish my breakfast, which means that I usually spend about 11 minutes just sitting watching the show that could be used for something else. Also, something that's usually ends up happening is that I don't just watch one episode of Rick and Morty, because you can't really just watch one episode of Rick and Morty. I usually end up watching at least two episodes and like I get stuck there. I found that if I just basically eat in silence and sit at the kitchen table without any sort of entertainment, I only spend those 10 minutes eating and not doing anything else, and then I can get to work or get to doing whatever else I want to be doing. You should be deliberate with your time. And that is not just with your productivity or like your work time, but also with your free time. So I think that what a lot of us end up doing is we sit at work and we dream of these things that we want to do when we have free time or when we're on a holiday or vacation or whatever. And then when we're actually on the holiday or when we actually have the free time, we actually spend most of it in bed in the morning, just scrolling through YouTube, watching random videos. And it just ends up being these things where you waste your free time on things that you don't actually feel like doing or you don't dream about doing when you're at work. Basically create a list of where do I want to spend my free time, and then making sure that when I have free time that I actually spend it there. If you feel like that's something that where you want to spend your time, you want to spend your time sitting in front of the TV watching a TV show, that's fine. It doesn't matter where you want to spend your free time. If you basically sit and watch the same TV show that you've seen 100 times and you end up wasting a lot of your day watching that when you feel like you actually wanted to do something else, then I think that's something that you should be careful of and try to think deliberately about. So I really suggest making a list of the things that you want to do in your free time and then having that list readily available so that when you have your free time, you can just take out that list and see what you can do. This again doesn't discriminate against any particular type of spending of free time. You can spend it like I did, just watching random videos on how to cure allergies that I don't have, or you can spend it doing something else that you feel like doing. But basically spend it where you want to be spending it. And the last tip is tip number 5, which I think is one of the most important tips, and that's creating a rigid workday routine. Basically means that you're working from home and you feel exhausted still and you feel like you have no energy to work, even though you're able to sleep in however long you want, you're able to go to bed whenever you want, you're able to work whenever you want, you're able to entertain yourself whenever you want. You still end up feeling more exhausted than you did when you went into an actual office and went to the regular work that you did before. And that's an issue that I've found a lot with myself. And that's something that I feel like a rigid workday routine really helps with. And that's something like, for instance, setting an alarm in the morning, getting up at the same time every day and going to bed at the same time every day. And I think that that's also probably the most difficult tip of all the tips that I've given you on this video. Basically getting up at the same time and going to bed at the same time is super difficult, especially when you don't really have to. You can get up whenever you want, it doesn't really matter, but try to create consistency here. So try to set a specific time and then make sure that you get up at that time every single day, because that way your body gets used to that routine and you get more energy throughout the rest of the day. The second part to this is get ready for work. So essentially in the morning, what I like to do is of course brush my teeth, and I hope that everyone is brushing their teeth in the morning. But other than that, I like to just get dressed as if I was going out to work or as if I was going to meet people. When we're working from home, we feel like, oh, we don't need to get dressed up. So you just wear your pajamas or just like sweaters or something comfortable. And I found that if I get ready and like put on jeans or put on something that's like real sort of clothes that I would go out in, then I have more energy throughout the day. I feel like you need to get to work more than you do when you're just wearing whatever. I don't know why, but my mom always told me when I was a kid to put on jeans even on the weekends. I really didn't want to do it, but I did put on jeans. And now when I'm older, I feel like this, for whatever reason, I feel more energetic and like less lethargic when I do put on jeans. For whatever reason, wearing jeans or like wearing something specifically probably on the legs, because that's where you usually like have something like that on, really does help me feel a little bit more energetic. Now that said, I don't always get dressed up. Sometimes I just wear sweatpants, but usually the rule is if you do wear jeans, you're gonna feel more productive and energetic. And the last part to this is set an end time to your day, because usually what we do is we might set an alarm in the morning and get up at a certain time, but when you're working from home, you can basically work at any time. It's really difficult to separate work, your work day, from your free time, and like it kind of gets jumbled up and mixed together. So you end up feeling like you have to work even at 9 p.m. That's something that I feel like if you set an end time to your day, then you get a more clear definition of when you're at work and when you're at home or when you're free from work. And that also has the benefit of basically giving you some sort of deadline. So if you're working on something, you don't have the entire day to complete that task. You only have until the end of your work day. If you allow infinite time for something, it's going to take infinite time to complete it. And if you allow restricted time for something, you're going to have that task completed within that restricted time. And that's something that I think is a struggle for a lot of people when they're working from home. They basically have infinite time. They could work at any time. And that means that they also oftentimes end up working at any time because they can. That's I think it's a really difficult thing and a problem, because having a deadline really allows you to forcefully speed up the process of completing the task. And that means that you get more done and you're more productive. And it also allows that contrast between the workday and your free time, and you're able to actually maybe enjoy your free time a little bit more than you would otherwise. Because again, that cloud of the work that you have to do feels like it's always like hovering above you when you're working from home, or that can be the case for some people. Having an end time really does help. And then lastly, just go to bed at the same time as well. And that relates to the first point, which is getting up, setting like an alarm in the morning. Try to be consistent with when you get up and when you go to bed. Get in at least 8 hours of sleep. Just consistency here is going to be super helpful. So that's basically my advice for being more productive when working from home. I've been doing it for a while now. Even when I was at school, I basically rarely would go to class, and I would often opt to work from home and just study from home. So I've been doing it for a while. I have used a lot of these techniques and I do find that they help me a lot. But I've also found that a lot of times you're just gonna have to accept the fact that some days you're just not gonna work that hard, and that's gonna have to be okay. And the way to combat that is to develop these routines that help you be super productive, or extra, you get more done on the days when you are productive. All right, so that's it for this one. I hope this was helpful. I really tried to give my best advice for the things that I've learned throughout these last couple of years of working from home. And yeah, I hope it made some sort of sense what I've been saying. So that's it for this one. I hope I'll see you in the next one.